there's a high when you go on stage and you see all these people like just loving your music and loving you and stuff, and there's these girls and all these people going worshiping me. And when you see all those people just going nuts for you, it's like, you know, it puffs you up inside. You're like, you know, I'm important. That's where drugs can creep in, and, you know, cocaine or whatever, methamphetamines crept in, and it all came from after drinking for me and my friends. And it seems like fun in the beginning. It's a lie, because it turns around on you. It starts to wear on your personality, starts to wear on your relationships, and everything is affected by it negatively. Everything. My real estate broker, Eric, he said, "Brian, I don't mean to be weird with you. I hope you don't take this the wrong way, but I felt the scripture like jump out at me. I've never done this before, you know, so I don't really know how to do this, but I felt like this would mean something to you. It's Matthew 11:28. Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." I remember all tweaked out. I looked up in the dictionary, weary. I looked up burdened, and I pulled the scripture apart, and I was like, well, I'm weary and burdened, and I need rest for my soul. And I didn't know if it was real, but you know, they invited me to church a couple weeks later, and I had received Christ at the church. I went home, neglected my daughter, got it all smooth and powdery. "Jesus, you got to take these drugs from me. Search me right now. Search my heart." In my head, I was like, okay, I'm going to accept Christ in front of everybody right now. Then I'm going to go home and snort drugs until I don't want to do them anymore. And that was my way of thinking. So I received Christ at the church. I went home, neglected my daughter, and put her in front of the TV. I remember I grabbed a $100 bill. I always used a $100 bill for some reason, pride or something. I chopped up my crystal meth, got it all smooth and powdery, and I snorted a big old line, and I held the bill, and I looked up, and I said, "Jesus, if you're real like that pastor said, then you got to take these drugs from me. Come into my life, come into my heart." And I just got quiet. I said, "Search me right now, search my heart." And I stayed silent, and I said, "You know I want to quit. You know I want to be a good dad for this kid. She lost her mother to drugs, and she's going to lose me if I don't quit. Amen."
Talk about the, when I read your book, the people that were around you, the other members of the band and other rock musicians, I mean, they just didn't believe this was real. There was a lot of skepticism on their part. Did they kind of think you were maybe worse off than you were on drugs?
I got one message from somebody saying, "I wish you would have died on drugs and then found Jesus and became a Christian."
Wow.
I was like, whoa, that's crazy. But, you know, don't be so angry, buddy. You know, but, you know what, it's just, you got to be real with this generation, and I wanted to do something that was just, I feel like I'm created, like, to go 100% in whatever I do, and so I dove in, and I wanted to be with my kid. I didn't want to tour so much, and I just, you know, I threw everything away and started a new life, and that was exciting to me, and everybody did, you know, a lot of people thought I went nuts, you know, because when you don't believe, when you don't have the faith, you just think it's kind of crazy, you know. I was like that, so I don't judge no one, because I was calling Christians crazy before I became one.
You're still making music.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's
what's different about the music you're making today?
Well,
you're not doing hymns and stuff.
No, it's very similar to what I used to play, but it's stuff that I went through. I sing about, yeah. You know, it's real to me, and I just I got a message I wanna talk about, you know, and it's like it's very unique, I think, and you know, I'm writing a book. I got my new book, Stronger, and it's about my strength with the scriptures and how the word of God has like transformed my life, you know, and it's like I'm doing new stuff that I never did before, and it's really exciting.
Well, the book is very powerful, and as you say, it's called Stronger, and it's about really developing spiritual strength and coming from a point at which a lot of people have looked at your life and said, you know, there's a guy that is going to be headed toward a dead end, no way he's ever going to make it, and here you sit talking about your faith.
My name is Chris, and this is my story. I grew up in a Christian home, yet rejected God. I wanted nothing to do with Christians or God, and when I was in about 7th grade, I started listening to the band Korn. I started accepting their views and beliefs, because they also hated God and Christians. The more I listened to their music, it wasn't until last year that I discovered a former guitarist named Brian Welch. Brian Welch was a legend in Korn, and he had left the band after 10 years to become a Christian. After that, I decided to get into his music and try to understand why he would leave such a big band. And I discovered his song called Love. And after that, after I heard the lyrics to that song, I broke down. And that was the first time I had really humbled myself in front of God. After that night, I gave my life to Christ.